This is the story of how we combined two loves, lace and the garden. We added crocheted lace to our bird bath. We think that you could add lace to any garden ornament, and it adds a little magic and a sweet handcrafted look, so we're going to show you all the steps with love for a country house. This bird bath was as plain as they come, but we knew when we bought it years ago that we'd try an experiment of adding crocheted lace to the surface and sealing it so that it looked carved. Sorry, fellow, that's not a dog dish. We gathered all the crocheted pieces we'd saved over the years, and the colors won't matter because we're going to be covering this lace with chalk paint. But before we attach the lace, we're going to smooth the edges that are rough with a metal file. Do this outside and make sure not to breathe in the dust. The edge of a round doily is the perfect shape for the base of our project, but remember that round doilies are often made as a spiral, so study them carefully to see where to cut them so that your edging will be even. The thing is, with crochet, it's perfectly imperfect. So our design may not be as perfect as something made by a machine, but on the plus side, crochet lace will stretch and compress if you need it to even out your design. Here, we're using sidewalk chalk to make marks to help us remember our placement. We brush on construction glue, we use tight bond, and then we flip the lace over. You've only got a few minutes to reposition this lace before the glue bonds. We use a damp cloth to sop up all the extra glue so that our lace design is clear. Cutting up crochet is not difficult, but don't stretch it too much after you cut it, and glue it to your project as soon as possible. And as for the design, we think it's important to leave lots of plain areas because these will make your lace and your arrangement stand out the best. Not to mention, it gives you a chance to add some antique effects, which we'll cover later. We'll leave lots of plain areas on this project to highlight the contrast with the lace. If you're in doubt about where to cut crochet, one tip is to look for links or single crochet. Here we also cut close to the edge of this heart because it looks very solid, like satin stitch. Oh, yes, you can do some cleanup trimming after you glue. And also, you can layer on more lace after gluing, like we've done here on our base. Well, that's it. Our design is complete and the gnome is back. I think he's wanting to get in on the act, but that's going to be one of our next projects with a few more surprises. But for now, our next step is chalk paint. We use Waverly Inspirations in plaster color. But really, you can use different shades of white. You can use other chalk paint. Statuary out in the garden tends to be off-white and more than one shade of white. Painting this project turned out to be very tricky. We used a 1-inch brush and a toothbrush to work the paint into the lace. We think the chalk paint will go a long way towards preserving this cotton lace, but of course we will seal it as best we can. And we're going to make sure this is protected from harsh temperatures too. We could see at this stage that brushing on the paint would be very time consuming. So, we used Bare Chalk Decorative Spray Paint in Pale Moon color. We built a small spray booth with cardboard and we used one full can for the base and the underside of the bowl. We're going to leave the inside of the bowl natural since it'll come into contact with a lot of standing water. The spray paint saved lots of time, but we still use the toothbrush between sprays to make sure that the paint isn't going to puddle inside the designs of our lace. And after a full can of spray paint, we went back to the brush and put on one more thin coat of our Waverly chalk paint in plaster shade. All different shades of white play nicely together on a surface like this, but for our next trick, we're conjuring up an antiquing formula that's new and experimental using artist chalk and Howard's Feed-In Wax. That's right, we're going to use furniture wax with artist chalks. So here we are with our artist chalk and a serrated knife, and we're going to scrape the side of the chalk and create a powdered tint on our palette. The thing is about this furniture polish, it has a type of oil that will become dry in time, but the ingredients will also help this penetrate our chalk paint and cement and allow us to do some blending with these beautiful vibrant colors. So this polish is orange oil and carnauba wax and beeswax, but I usually use just the oil. If you squeeze the bottle, the wax will come up from the bottom, but if you pour it, the oil will tend to pour without the wax. Blend it with your tint, and using a small brush, a square one's good for getting into those little recesses, and start painting the flat areas or plain areas and some of the holes of your lace with whatever tint you like. I tended to use greens, blues, because I love tropical colors, but in a minute I'll show you how I also use terracottas and golds too. Really, you can use any color you like. This antiquing method allows you to wipe back the color quite a bit, and we do that a lot here. But also, you'll be able to remove this for quite some time. But already, in just 24 hours, when we filled the bird bath today and water splashed on the rim, we were able to rub it and the color did not come off. But there were other areas where it was still very soft and you could remove some of it with a baby wipe or a damp cloth. In the early stages though, we were able to apply the chalk directly and finger paint, which was a lot of fun and a little bit easier to blend than the paintbrush. Okay, this bird bath is ready for the garden. What happens next? We'll let this cure for 5 days outdoors under a tarp if it rains. Then we'll give it a spray with Mod Podge Matte Sealer and follow that with a light coat of a concrete sealer, also in a matte finish. And that's it. Now where's that gnome? It's his turn. Click the like button if you'd like to see the little thumb turn blue and a gnome get a makeover. And go to stephiemccarthy.com for more love for a country house. Click the sun logo to subscribe.